Hello everyone, welcome to another tutorial from WindowsLovers.com. This is me, your host Prajwal, and in today's video we're going to see how to solve system thread exception not handle issue, or what we want to call it, BSOD, or blue screen of death error on Windows 10 or any Windows system for that matter. So let's get started. First thing, what is system thread exception not handle issue? So when you receive this blue screen of death error, so this basically means that your system has run into a device or run into an issue that's stopping Windows function properly. Okay, so what happens is there's kernel panic, or there's some sort of system process that is actually being affected by a certain process or certain hardware or certain driver or certain application that you might have installed that is creating this issue. So let's see how we can troubleshoot this. Okay, there's different scenarios. So the first scenario is you cannot get into your system at all. So what happens is every time you start your system, it sort of takes you to the login screen, and then it gives you that BSOD or system thread exception handle error. So, and it just, your system just goes into this continuous loop when it restarts. So how do you solve that issue? First thing is you want to go into safe mode, or you want to restore your system to an early stage if you have it. So let's see how that's done. So first, what you want to do is you want to get into the advanced system recovery mode. So if your system is going there by default, where you get different standard repair options, that's fine. If not, what you can do is you can just restart your system, long press your power button, and now it's turned off. So what you want to do is you want to turn it on, and when it goes to the BIOS screen, what you want to do is long press your power button again and shut it down once more. All right, so we want to turn it on again, and most of the computers by this time you will go into the advanced system recovery mode. If it's not, then long press that again. And leave it for a couple of seconds, turn it back on. Now it's preparing for automatic repair. It's diagnosing your PC. Alright, so it says your PC didn't start correctly. Please restart system. So if your system is going into the loop, you don't want to restart. So if your computer is directly going to this automatic repair option, it's fantastic, perfect. If not, then you just follow whatever I just did and you click on advanced options. And you can either troubleshoot, you can use a device to reset, which I don't think you have. If you do, you can just use that to reset it. But before you do reset your device, you want to troubleshoot more. So click on troubleshoot. Click on advanced option. The first thing you want to try is you want to try and do startup repair, which probably your system has already tried to do before giving you the BSOD error. So I'm just going to skip that part, but you can do that if you like. Second thing is you can try and do a system restore. Okay, system restore points are either created automatically when you install any applications or make any changes to your system. For example, if there's any Windows update, you'll have a system restore point. But if not, you can just give it a shot and see if you have any automatic restore points. So click on system restore and choose an account. So that's my account. Enter your password. Now it's saying system restore files and settings, so click on next. And now you might or might not have a restore point. So for example, I have three restore points. One is 27th of May, 16th of May, and 12th of May. So if you know there is a system restore point which is actually before the BSOD error you've received, so you can try and restore your system to that point. So if, for example, if I restore my system to 16th of May, what happens is any changes or any installations I've done on my system after that will be cleared, as in any changes, or for example, if you might have any files. So you will, what you can do is if you think you have any files and application that you might need, you can just click on that system restore point and scan for affected programs, and it will give you a list, any programs and drivers that will be deleted, or any programs and drivers that might be restored. Okay, so if you think you're all good to go, click on that restore point and click on next and click on finish, and then your system will be restored to the point where you think you don't have any error message. Okay, so this eliminates your BSOD or system thread exception 5 out of 10 times, at 50% of your error. But if you need more restore points, you can click on show more restore points, and then it will give you more restore points that probably will be a bit older as well. So you can try and restore your system to any older system restore points. Okay, now what if system restore is not helping you? So what you can do is, I'm just gonna go cancel, gonna go troubleshoot, advanced option. What we're gonna do is, you're gonna boot into safe mode. So in safe mode, you don't have any extra hardware or any extra applications running. You only run the basic or essential Windows processes that are needed to make sure that your Windows functions properly, and we can sort of dissect the problem and uninstall anything that you might have installed, or if you remember anything, any Windows update or anything like that before you actually receive the BSOD. Okay, click on startup settings. And you can see restart to change options, such as enable disable mode, enable safe mode. Click on restart, and now it will give you different options. So what you want to do is, you want to try and enable safe mode with networking. So if you have a LAN cable, you can use LAN cable to access internet. So what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to press F4, which means enable safe mode. So if you get into safe mode with networking, you have got to have a LAN cable or a LAN port connected to your computer for you to be able to connect to the internet and download any drivers that's needed. I'm just going to enter my password. Once you are in safe mode, what you can do is, now if you know any drivers that are creating the issue, okay, so if you are paying attention to that blue screen of death error, it gives you the .sys file at the end, and you can just do a Google search with what that sys file or whatever the file name is related to, and it will probably give you a hardware name. For example, if it's something called RHV64.sys, is usually a Realtek device. If it's something else, if you just do a Google search with that file name and BSOD at the end, you will probably get a hardware name that's related to that device. So what you can do is, you can either uninstall that device or update the system driver. But if you don't have a LAN connection, you cannot update your driver for sure, because you don't have internet connection. But if you have a LAN cable and a LAN port on your laptop or a system, you can definitely try that. So what I'm gonna do now is, for example, my Realtek or my audio device is creating that issue. So what I'm gonna do is click on start, search for device manager. Open device manager, and now I'm gonna find it. For example, generic PNP monitor. This is what's creating the issue for me after doing the Google search for the file name. What I'm gonna do is right click and uninstall this device, and I'm just gonna click on uninstall. Okay, I'm not gonna install it now because there's no issue with my system, but you just uninstall that device and you do a restart and see if that has helped. Okay, if that hasn't helped, what you want to do is, you want to come back into the safe mode again. What you want to do is, the system, your Windows has a tool called Event Viewer, an application called Event Viewer, which logs each and every event that happens inside Windows 10, Windows 7, Windows 8, and you can sort of see what's happening on the behind the scenes. So what you want to do is start and search for Event Viewer. It's the first one that comes up here. Open that. And once you're inside Event Viewer, what you want to do is just expand it. And on the left, there's Windows Logs. Expand that. And you go to System. Now, it has logged so many error messages. Okay. What you want to do is, you want to come to the right-hand side and click on Filter Current Log. And what you want to tick is, just tick on Event Level. Tick on Critical, Warning, and Error. And click on OK. This will list all of the error messages or any of the events that has created any kernel panic or created any issues on your computer in the past, or critical. So for example, there's a critical error for me. Just sort of go through these files and try to note down the date and time that the BSOD was occurred. Or for example, if you had a BSOD this morning, so make sure you note down that time and look for any event that has happened in that time frame. So you can do the same with system, and you can do the same for application. Just filter those out. Now, if you find that event that is creating the issue, you can sort of dissect it more in the future steps. Okay, so once you have that file name and you can see that event ID, and if you get more information, you can sort of work towards the resolution. If not, we move on to the next step. So next step is actually blocking that file that's creating this issue. So what you can do is, you can trick the system into thinking that that file doesn't exist in the first place, okay? And that is creating that system thread exception not handle issue. So what you wanna do is, you wanna click on start, search for CMD, and make sure you right click on it, and run as administrator, or there's an option here as run as administrator. You want to do this because otherwise you won't be able to rename that file. So once the CMD is open, what you want to do is go to C, type in CD space C drive slash, I'll leave this link or leave this command in the description as well, Windows slash system 32 slash drivers, and hit enter. So what this does is now you're working inside the folder that stores all the driver files, that .sys file. So when you receive that BSOD error, you will receive, usually most of the times, not all the time, but most of the times you will receive a something .sys file, something meaning the name of the driver that's creating the issue. So what you want to do now is type in REN and type in the exact file name with the extensions. For example, it's called FAULTY .sys, so that's the file name that's creating the issue, or that's the driver that's creating the issue, faulty the sys and space, and rename it to something else. So for example, if you want to rename it to fault.sys, if I press enter, it'll probably give me an error message because there's nothing with the name faulty.sys. But if you have the right file name and if you put in the right name, what happens is you don't get any error message. It just skips. When you press the enter, you will just go to the next step, and that means the file has been renamed. So technically speaking, that file doesn't exist in your system, which is creating that issue. So now you should be able to log into your system. So after you restart, you should be able to log into the system since that file hasn't replaced. So now after restarting the system, if you get another BSOD error, make sure you look at the file name that's creating that issue, which will allow you to do the further troubleshooting. Now on to the next step. What you want to do is you want to uninstall any applications you might have installed before you receive this error message. So what you want to do is start, go to control panel and click on programs and features, and you want to uninstall any application you think, or any application you've installed and after that you receive this error. For example, you installed Telegram, and before installing Telegram everything was running fine and there was no issue. So what you want to do is you want to just uninstall Telegram and see if that helps. Okay, moving to next step is actually checking if there was any major system update. So what happens is every time Microsoft releases a Windows update, chances are that any drivers or any hardware devices that's on your system is not compatible with their drivers, or the drivers you have installed for the hardware devices is probably not compatible with the latest version or the latest Windows update from Microsoft. So what you can do is, staying in the same program and features, on the left hand side you will see view install updates. So click on view installed updates. So now how you find out that is, on the right hand side there's a column that says installed on. So if you click on it, it will sort it from ascending to descending order, so depending on when was the last time any update was installed. So on 13th of May there was a security update. Please bear in mind that you cannot uninstall all of them, you can only uninstall some of the, for example, you cannot uninstall Service Stack, you cannot uninstall update for removal of Adobe Flash Player and things like that. So what you can do is you can see for any updates that was installed on the day or the day before you were receiving this error message, try uninstalling that just from up here, and then restart your system and see if that has helped. And now the final step and the last thing I would do before I actually go and reinstall Windows or reset my Windows. So on the top right corner there is a way on how I show you how you can upgrade or how you can reset your Windows 7 or Windows 10 to do another installation, or just a refresh of your Windows 10 installation. So it's top right corner, or it's probably in the description as well. So before we do that, what we want to do is we want to check the dump file. All right, so the next step is to create and read the dump file. So what happens is every time your system crashes or every time there is a blue screen of death error, what happens is you can set a setting, or you can set the Windows in such a way that it creates a dump file for you to go back and to dissect and see what the issue is. Okay, so first let's see how you can set up your system. For example, if you cannot boot into your Windows, what you can do is you can do the same thing from safe mode like we did before. So when you're back in safe mode, what you want to do is you want to open your file explorer and you go to your this PC, right click and click on properties. On the right hand side you click on advanced system settings, and now under startup and recovery click on settings again, And under system failure, under write debug information, what you got to make sure is you have selected small memory dump, and then you have your directory where you would want to save this file, and click on OK, click on OK again. And once your system starts, okay, so now if you don't have internet connection on your computer, you might have to take that file and keep it on a different computer and run these commands or run this application that I'm going to show you in the next step. Or if you have internet connection, if you are booting into safe mode with networking, what you do is you go to this website called nearsoft.net. I'll leave all the download links in the description. So what this does is it gives you a quick summary of what's creating the issue. For example, in your blue screen of death, you don't see a particular file name, or the screen shuts off very, or the system restarts very quickly. So what you can do is this application will read that for dump file that we just created or asked our system to create, and it will give you exactly what's happening. Okay, so you want to go here and you want to go download links at the bottom, click on that, and then you want to download blue screen with full install / uninstall support, and you can open that after the download is completed. Now, I'm not asking you guys to do this on the computer that's facing issue, because I don't know what situation is. This is always a good idea to do it on different machine, but you'll have to make sure that you set up your system to receive that dump file. So click on next, install, and just click on run. Now what you want to do is, so what happens is, by default, if your system has crashed, if you're using this on your system, or what you can do is, for example, if you have a dump file on your desktop, what you want to do is you go on options, advanced options, and you go on browse, and you set the folder to your desktop, if wherever the file, the dump file is, click on OK, and after that it will load that dump file here. At the moment I don't have any dump files to show you guys, but after it's loaded, if you double click on it, it will be exactly like it shows on the instructions. It will tell you what file is creating the issue and what exactly the problem. For example, here it says a problem has detected and Windows shut down. The problem seems to be caused by the following file, TCP/IP, and it will give you a technical information with the stop code. So this code, you can use this code to do more research or more troubleshooting on the error message as well. Okay, and final step is, if nothing's working, what you would want to do is you would want to do a refresh of your Windows. And I'm going to quickly show you where you can do that, but I'll also have another dedicated video on how to refresh or reinstall Windows. So you go to Windows, you go to click on start, go to settings, and you go to update and security, and on the left hand side there's a recovery. You go there and there's option to reset this PC, so you click on get started, and you have options to keep your files or remove everything. So when you keep your files, what happens is anything in your documents folder or your desktop folder remains, but any applications or any settings you might have will be removed. And if you click on remove everything, this is like reinstalling Windows. I wouldn't say completely as a reinstalling Windows, but it is very close to completely installing a new version of Windows on your system. Okay, so I hope some of these steps have helped you fix your system thread exception handle issue or the blue screen of death error. If you need any assistance, please leave a comment below. Subscribe for more. Please make sure you like this video if this was helpful in any means way. Thank you. You have a nice day, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.